Hey Ryan, can you hear me? Okay, your GoToWebinar screen's not moving. It's still on the title slide. Probably because you're streaming, huh? Okay. Yep, we're good now. Thanks. I can't tell, Ryan. I'm only listening remotely.
There are people who say anything in GoToWebinar, I can swap over to a headset mic really, really quick, so it's not a big deal.
It looks like it's fine, Ryan.
Okay, great.
Everything is good.
Okay, thank you, everybody. But the Rhino Harmonic, this is the one that we were talking about. So this is a daily view, and you can easily see why. You know, the first conclusion that Frank had was that it's maybe an eighth stop or an eighth indicator or a Fibonacci. Frank uses a lot of Fibonaccis as well. We talk about this quite often. But it's not. What it's doing is it's taking information from January and December, and then it's plotting out and forcing these levels moving forward. So what you're getting is a very static set of market structure levels that here in the case of ADI, you know, we got an immediate push up. Now, given all of these are set, okay, so none of these are being built out as prices doing something. It's not, well, now the price is going up, so let's draw a line here, and now it's going down, let's draw a line here. It's not doing all that. At the end of January, all of these levels are set for the entire year. So as price comes up, it's hitting these key levels of market structure. What market structure is areas in the chart that institutional brokers, professional traders, hedge funds, these are the levels that they're looking at to be placing their bets on, you know, the direction of the market, what it's going to be doing. So as you can see here in February, we got a nice bump up. It tested that market structure level, came all the way down, and we already have these levels out. So as price is coming down and testing, we know almost immediately that this is going to be an area of support. You know, we have a couple of bars coming down, wicking back up and holding at that structure. So we know that that is an area that the industry is seeing as a level of support. And, you know, what ensues afterwards is some upward momentum. Now, a couple of these indicators takes a little bit of time to actually get in and use them on your charts, because there's a saying that we've always used in the office. If you put enough lines on a chart, something is going to hit. So what we're going to go through over the seminar is showing you that this isn't just throwing a lot of lines and hitting it, but we're going to show you example after example after example of areas where market is hitting these specific levels and having an immediate reaction based off of these points. And, you know, it's just nice to know also moving forward, you know, if we're in March, we already know where these levels are. So we have these key points, regardless of what the market is doing, regardless if COVID hits here in March, as price is coming down, we have levels that we're confident in. And here on ADI, we have one of the Rhino reversal strategies, and it does, there's a little bit of a delay on the strategies, and it's intentional. So you'll see a lot of these where you find these bottoms, and then it's a little bit after the move. That's an intentional entry, and we'll explain that also in our webinar course or our seminar course. But here's a couple of areas where, okay, so market structure came back up, came back down, hit again, and then up here at resistance. So we just marked out a couple of the key levels on this particular chart. The next one is the Rhino Summary. This is actually one of my favorite tools. I actually built this around the time of the OmniTrader 2020 upgrade. I was really wanting to get something in there that was, you know, that I had a hand in. And unfortunately, I wasn't able to get it completed before that update, but we were able to get it into this package. So it is going to be available. Now, there's been two versions of this. The first one was a hand-coded one that I did. And if you were in the Trade Strong, you got a copy of an early version of that, and it's great. It works. It does what it needs to do. It adds resource to your computer, as some of you guys have probably seen, and it has some areas of gaps where the logic wasn't all filled out. But what I did is I sat down with John Luca, and we talked about what we needed to be doing. We redefined all of the levels based off of the indicators. As I said, there's dozens. There's literally 24 plus indicators being used in this system. And what it's doing is it's hitting all of the key levels. And some of my levels were eyeball. So we went back and we researched where are the bullish and bearish areas of each one of these indicators, combined them into this really fantastic tool. So you get an early idea of what the market is going to be doing, when it's shifting, when the sentiment is shifting. So let's go down here and look at the chart. We can take a look. So over here in, thanks, Don. I just got your email. Thank you. Over here in the 22nd, this is on a real-time chart, we see that there's some bearish sentiment. And basically, there's a couple of different levels or applications that this tool is going to be used for. First, it has a running count. So based on how many of the indicators are showing bullishness, bearishness, or a neutral sentiment, it's going to give you a value. So it might be a value of 13. And you know, if it's 13 in the red, it means that there's 13 bearish indicators firing at that particular time. The second component we've added in is a sentiment ranker. And why this is important is because now you can take this indicator and use it effectively inside of your OmniScans. You can use it as a filter in your strategies. You know, you can use it anywhere inside of OmniTrader that you're able to use indicators. And basically, it has a strong buy, a neutral, a sell, and a strong sell sentiment. So what you could do is go into your strategy, and this is something I'm going to cover in the seminars as well. I have it all planned out. But you can go into your filter and say, you know, okay, I have all these signals, but if I don't have at least a buy, which is the pinkish color down here, if I don't at least have, or that's a sell, but it's the green one, the light green one. If I don't at least have a buy, the entry is passed, or I want a strong buy. I want to know that there is so much confluence behind the trades, you know, there's no way that I could possibly miss. So you're able to add those in. This is one of the chart templates that we are going to build in the class. It's very, very simple. It's basically reflecting the same information. So I didn't think it was really something to add into the package as we were going. It kind of seemed like fluff, and I wanted to really give you guys the meat, not fluff. So it's just kind of representing areas that are corresponding with the strength of super buy in the sentiment. Now, the great thing about this is you can use it not only on you know, the stock that you're looking at, but you can also look at it on any of the indexes. Again, none of this is going to be based off of volume, so you'll know, you know, the SPX or the NASDAQ Composite, they don't generally have volume depending on your data provider. So a lot of indicators would have problems that are using that. So this, you can sit and plot this on any of the indexes, any of the ETFs, and then you're getting that overall look. And with obviously OmniTrader 2020, we added in those higher time frame indicators. So now you can even take it and say, I want to, you know, in the real time, I want to see what the daily or the weekly, you know, market sentiment or market summary is. So a lot of power has been put into this. You will still be able to use the old one. You know, it's still there. It's quite different though. So. The next one is the Rhino First Print. And as I said right off the bat, this one for the last 8 years has been called Rhino Spy. And I've talked about Rhino Spy, so all of you that have been waiting and really yearning to get that Rhino Spy, I've have probably 36 emails from people during our sessions really wanting me to put that out. That's what this one is. So now it's completely available to you with the Rhino Suite. Now, what is unique about this? The Rhino, actually, let me make sure there's not anything on here. So yeah, it's an indicator that takes the first print of the day. So if you're not familiar with the first print, there is pre-market data and post-market data. So you have pre-market, then you have your normal session, and then you have post-market data. What this does is it takes that very first tick of data. And again, I built this for the SPY. So the first tick of data in 2020 is at 4 a.m. Now, it used to be at 3:15. I don't know why it's changed, but for 2020, it's at 4 a.m. And often, it's just going to be a little wick. It's just going to be a little dash like this. Sometimes it's a bar. Sometimes it's a large bar. But what this does is it takes that value, and then it calculates all of the levels based off that value. So much like the Rhino Harmonic, there is no changing. There is no, you know, prices coming down here, now we'll draw a line. It's not like that. These levels are all built out. They're pre-calculated. They never change. And you'll see this is the SPY. This is pre-market. So this is 4 a.m. And what we're seeing is through this trading, obviously there are some key levels that are constantly hit, right, throughout the session. Now, what I'm going to teach you in the seminar is how to utilize these levels pre-market. Okay, we're going to talk about how to use the SPY, which, you know, is the ETF for the index. So, you know, it follows suit. So I'm going to show you how to know exactly where you should be looking at for entries, how to use this tool to identify key areas right off the bat. So in the pre-market, and I'm not going to get too in-depth in this, but in pre-market on the SPY, you'll often get these wicks. Now, it's not so much the wick that's important, it's the levels that they are reacting to, okay? So as you're coming down, you know, for in a lot of cases, just visually, you can tell where the bottom is going to be for the session, or where the high is based on that movement. So we've added in, excuse me. Oh, so much talking, sorry. We've added in a new custom VWAP. So this is not the same as the one what's in profit band. This one is specifically calculated for lower time frame, real-time charts, and it's absolutely incredible. So as you get these levels, what it gives you is, once you know where your trading range is, you're looking for these key levels all the way down or all the way up, and then we're going to talk about how you can utilize this VWAP with the first print to give you exactly all the information. Now, you don't have to trade the SPY, okay, or the DIA, or the Qs. It works on all three of them. We built this to where you're able to now do it on any one of your stocks. You can customize it, you can arrange it, and I'm going to show you how to do that in the seminar. So it's no longer just the SPY. That's why we called it the first print. It's a lot more incredible than the indicator, or than this chart makes it look. But I'll show you in the seminar exactly how to use this. I use it every day to know exactly what the market is doing. Actually, I took a couple of short trades on the SPY based off of this particular chart. That's why I pulled it, both in pre-market before our chart talks and during the session, which took us into the post-market. Now, you might be asking, how can you trade pre- and post-market? Not everybody can. You have to be able to use level 2 data in order to be able to trade that. Depending on your broker, you may or may not have that. However, what we can do is identify where the levels are, understand what the market is going to do, and use this towards our advantage, towards anything else that we're going to be trading. All right. All right, so the next one. This is the one that Al Fife worked with me on. I believe it was in 2014, maybe. I had just created the Rhino. At the time, I had coded my own whole moving average. I didn't have the calculations for the one that was actually out there, so I kind of took the idea and what I read, and I created one, and then I added my own spin on it. And basically, the whole moving average, if you're familiar with it, is a zero lag moving average. It follows pretty true, unlike a simple moving average or exponential moving average or something like that. It follows a little closer, so you're not getting as much delay in the movement. But what I did is I took that, and for the history of the bar or history of the line, it's exactly that. It's this really finely tuned line. What I did, though, is on the two bars that are current bars, I've added some delay. And the delay is to help confirm the direction of the moves. All right? So here is the indicator, or the system rather, and what you'll notice is there's the actual cross here in the middle of March, where it changes from red to blue, but my signals don't start showing up for a couple of bars. Now, there's a couple of calculations that go into it. It's not just two bars. There have to be some criteria met that go along with that. Now, there's two, one thing, well, something that I want to talk to you about on this chart because I didn't think about it. We built the strategies, each using this as a signal generator. However, in this example, I used a 20 period, which is a pretty quick moving one, so you're able to catch these nice reversals. Excuse me. In the strategy, we use a 50, so that's why it doesn't match up exactly. But again, during the seminar, I'm going to show you, I'm going to handhold all the way through, and we're going to have a lot of time to just sit in and really refine these. But this is kind of what the whole moving average is, and it's really just looking at the conditions that are happening, and there's two separate conditions that have to be present in order to generate the signal. But it's turned out to be extremely powerful. Actually, Jeff, after I gave him the files, he put them into a strategy and he goes, well, that was easy. I just got over 70% my first try. And we refined and redesigned based off of that. So it's absolutely incredible. And then once we have, now that we know all of the things that come into it, we have two different strategies. We kind of just talked about it there. But we've combined all of these new assets, the Rhino summary, the hull, which is obviously the signal, which is the Rhino HMA, not hull, and then the Rhino harmonic. We combined them all into just incredibly powerful strategies. I've just been blown away. I wanted to actually show them in chart talks, my data went out on my OmniTrader right before the show came up, so I wasn't able to pull it back up before. But maybe tomorrow I'll do that for those of you guys who show up to that. But I'm going to go through, I'm going to break down exactly what's going on in each one of the strategies. I'm going to give you tips that I've personally found to change it or take it from 73% to over 80%, which is just incredible on your end of day. So that's what we're going to do in the seminar. I'm super excited about it. I've been looking at the signals, just mind blown. Here's an example. Didn't plan that one at all, but I actually forgot it was the next one. Here's an example on ADSK. It's had two trades. Like I said, the Rhino reversal is looking for really strong reversal kinds of trades. But this trade here, starting in September of last year, caught the entire thing for 29% gain and 48% gain here after the COVID reversal. Just incredible, incredible returns. If you were to take just 100 shares and take these two trades, this would have been a $12,379 trade. Yes, this one was picked out. I put it here because it's a great example. But the great thing is, they are all over the place. It's not like it's hard to find these. You know, anytime you have just a mechanical strategy out of the box that's hitting at over 70%, it's not hard to find these kinds of trades. But I'm going to show you how to improve on this exponentially. So, yeah, those are the strategies. Just incredible. Next, you're going to have the Rhino Omni scans. These ones, again, are using the powerful Rhino summary along with a couple of other basic Omni scan indicators that you're able to use, and they've been finely tuned to give you signals that are going to be conducive to win with the Rhino suite. You have a bullish, a bearish, and obviously if you have Omni scan, they are a fantastic value. And then we're going to move on to the education. As I said right off the bat, this is a concept that no one in this room has a real good grasp on. I know that. Even when I've talked about it on Trade Strong, and when I've talked about it over on Chart Talks, you can see just briefly, but nobody has a full understanding. But that's why I'm here. I'm going to teach you everything I know about this system. It's going to be 2 weeks, four sessions. They wanted to put a value of this of $600 on it. Said no, it has to be included. So we are adding it in. It's a two-week course recorded for your, you know, viewing pleasure afterwards. And, of course, I'm always available to help out via email as well. Before we Actually, this is, I was going to go to over to the website. Actually, I guess I can. Whoops. Here we go. If you haven't seen it yet, the Rhino Suite website is over at nirvanasystems.com/Rhino Suite. For those of you who are over on YouTube, I did put this into the description, so you can get there. I will post it over into our Facebook, or maybe Angela can post it over there as well, so you can get to it. But the address is pretty simple, nirvanasystems.com/Rhino Suite. Have some really great examples on here. This chart here on Pepsi, this is from 2 days ago. It basically caught every move that you could do over the last 2 days, both directions. It's just really fantastic. Gives a good description of what's going on. It breaks down the strategies a little bit more. So if you're on the fence and you want some more information, that's definitely the place to go and get it. So the price of it is originally $695. The Rhino Suite we're going to do for, like I said, almost $600. But for the early bird special, it's $495. It's a killer deal. That one trade alone, $12,000. It's not hard to find those. So, you know, this definitely is going to pay itself off very, very quickly. But for, you know, our Nirvana Club members, you also have that additional discount on top of it. And a lot of you have already gone out and bought it. I've gotten emails from a ton of people so far telling me how much they like it and how excited they are for the education. So if you have any questions, feel free to give our support a call. The price, it's only going to be good until next Tuesday. That's when the training starts, and I don't know if we're gonna keep it the way it is. But don't wait, don't hesitate. It's now's the time. Order before June 2nd and save. Now, Angela, I said I was going to go for 25 to 30. I'm pretty close to that. Do you have any questions out there?
We have a number of questions, Ryan. Would you like me to read them to you?
Yeah, that'd be wonderful.
Okay. Keith wants to know if Rhino uses VWAP.
There is one indicator in there that does the first print does use VWAP. I have that up on the screen. It's not the same VWAP that's included in profit bands. It's very specific to this tool as far as the calculations. It's not far off. I mean, it's not a new mathematical, you know, definition of VWAP, but this one is extremely accurate. So yes, it is in there. It's not separate,
okay,
though. It's part of the verse print.
Gotcha. Okay, thanks. Robert is asking about the 2-minute time frame. Was it tested as more profitable as opposed to the other intraday time frames? Mm-hmm. Why was that selected?
Yes, the 2-minute time frame was the highest for the real time, and Jeff went through, you know, various iterations of it to come out with the one what's the most profitable. Now, the reason we kind of kept it at 2-minute is the fact that for the a couple of the tools, since they were built for these really finite times, it kind of was an intermediate between a 1-minute chart, what not everybody wants, the volatility or the quick pace of a 1-minute, and a 5-minute. So it kind of is the best of both worlds. It does work on anything, so you are definitely not limited to a 2-minute, but we did find that the results were pretty spectacular at 2.
Okay, thanks. Question from Philippe. He says, I don't see any short signals. Why?
That is a good question. Your real-time strategy, actually, I think maybe over on the website, the real-time strategy does have shorts. The end of day, the shorts are fine. I'm not exactly sure why we didn't put it in. It does lower just slightly. I think it goes from 73% profitable over the year to like 68.5% or 70%. So there is a little bit of a difference there. But in the webinar or in the seminar, I'm going to show you how to do that, and we're going to go in depth, like I said, over absolutely every aspect of this. So it is possible to have them in there. It's not difficult, and it doesn't deplete the value of it at all.
Right. Okay. Next question is from Keith. He says, "Is this applicable to trading weekly options?"
I'm going to say yes, but I want to caveat that with I'm not an option trader, but what I do know of options is having the idea where the levels are. Let's see. Knowing, that's not a good example. Let me get over to a harmonic. Okay, so if you're trading the weekly options, knowing kind of where your next market structure level is, and I'm using market structure very specifically here because it's not necessarily support, it's not necessarily resistance. It in a lot of cases, it kind of turns out to be very close to it, but it's not the same. So I'm using market structure in a very particular way. But knowing where these levels are ahead of time can definitely help you plan out not only your weekly, but your just regular options as well. So yes. Now, as far as the strategy goes, I you know, we haven't tested it on options. You can do that, and that won't be covered. Again, I'm not an options master. Thank you.
Okay. All right. A clarification on the deadline. That is actually July 2nd, not June 2nd.
Yes.
So
did I put June?
A couple people corrected us on that.
Oh, I did put June. That's me. That's all me.
That's okay.
July 2nd.
That's okay. We are recording this webinar. We will automatically send it to you. Rhino is included in your lifetime membership if you are a life member, so you will automatically get a link for that. What else? Oh, when is support for Visual Trader going to be added?
Next pre-release. Barry is working on it. Actually, I was working with him today on it, so it will be out the next Visual Trader pre-release.
Awesome. All right. Question from Donald. Is this day trade only, or can you find swing trades with it also?
So yes and no. So the strategies are built. Intraday swing trading, yes. The intraday strategies work very well for catching both of them. Actually, let me get back over to the website again. I don't have my system set up for it right now, but if we come up here to, oops, that's the website right here. So you're able to catch the swing moves pretty quick. Here's an example here on Pepsi where it caught a long, exited, and then caught the short. So you're able to swing trade that way. As far as the end of day strategy, it's more the reversal. It's more looking for a shift in sentiment, kind of like if you were to be trading with a moving average. You're kind of looking for price to cross levels. So it's a little bit more tuned towards that, but the real-time one definitely catches swings and can be used for swing trading.
What about Forex?
Again, it's not using any volume. It's not using anything that would be restrictive. So yes, you can use this on Forex. It has not been tested on Forex, I will say that. So some of the premises, although readily available in stocks, might not translate exactly. But I'll show you how to get past that in the seminar as well.
All right, great. Great job, Ryan.
Well, thank you. Well, I just, I was really nervous, you know, kind of like when, it's been 8 years or so that I've been kind of loving this and trying to get people on board at the office. So when Jeff put it into the planner as something that we were going to do, I was kind of elated, but then like the fear, it was like, oh man, what if everybody, you know, what if they don't get it? But extremely powerful. You're going to be super excited about it. Again, the training starts Tuesday, recorded seminar Tuesday. Thursday is going to be the live session. Get in, watch that seminar, have your questions ready because we're going to have a full hour of me showing you things and it's going to be really interactive. So I'll be taking your questions. We'll bring up your examples. We'll bring up your questions or anything that you have. So it's going to be a really, really exciting time. It's going to be a complete master course. Outside of that, I don't have anything. Go ahead.
Will you be starting your classes with jokes?
Duh, it's me.
the famous Ryan bad joke.
Yes.
Bad joke of the day.
Bad joke of the day. Each session will come with a bad joke. So that's worth the price right there.
Okay. But, one more question that just came in from Mark. He says, can we use this with some sort of RT scans so that we get signal alerts on a given list?
Yes. Oh, actually, you know what? I'll have to talk with, I said that really quick because I use market scans all the time. But I'll have to talk with Kosei, and it wouldn't be available right away, but we could have that added in. So real-time scans would work if you were
Okay.
using market scans. Again, not ready this moment, even though I just said yes, but we can have that added.
Okay, great. Well, thanks so much, Ryan.
Well, yeah, and again, I want to thank everybody for showing up. Emails will come out. Head on over there. If you have any questions, let us know. Everybody is ready, and enjoy the stampede. Oh, see, I just came up with that bad joke. Ready for the stampede.
Good one.
All right. All right, everybody. You have a fantastic evening, and look forward to talking to you.